Hi, I'm Laura, and today I'm going to show you how to make a spinach and ricotta agnolotti with burnt butter and sage. So this is a really, really quick and simple recipe. So the first thing we're going to do is add our fresh agnolotti to our boiling water. So my first tip for this recipe is to just chuck the whole packet in whole. Don't break up the pasta. It's going to do its own thing once you add it into the water. And give it a really gentle stir. So the next thing we're going to do is start to burn our butter. So I'll show you how to do this. It's really simple and really quick. So we're just going to put the butter in the fry pan. And the first thing we're going to do is let that melt away. So my butter's melted away, and now we're going to let it go for another few minutes until it turns that slightly brown colour, because we want it to get a really cool burnt flavour to it, but we don't want it to be black, so we have to watch it really carefully. I'm now going to add my sage leaves as well, while this process is happening. So they get really crispy in there. Burnt butter and sage sauce is one of my all-time favourite sauces. It's super quick, super tasty, and it reminds me of going to my nonna's house every Sunday for lunch, where she'd always have a burnt butter and sage ravioli on the menu, and us kids would go crazy over it. So I love making it at home, and it's actually quite elegant. Flavours are so complex by the time the dish is finished. The colour of the butter has turned that light golden colour, so we've burnt it just perfectly. And it's going to have a beautiful caramelised taste to it. So the next step to do is add our freshly cooked pasta. Turn the heat off now. And we're done. So this is my take on my nonna's spinach and ricotta agnolotti with burnt butter and sage.